Hello everyone, I'm Golden Ashwini, working in Rogni College of Engineering and Technology in Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. In this video, we are going to see planning. On completion of this video, the students will be able to explain what is planning and its importance. And students will be able to explain what is planning and their examples, and they can also explain what are the features of planning. So before entering into the topic, we need to know the basic, right? The planning. So planning is the most basic of all management functions. There is no choice between planning and no planning. The choice is only with regard to the method and techniques used to plan. Most of us are planning many things in our day-to-day lives. Frequently, we plan to do official work, improve our careers, plan our investment, build own houses, do business, and so on. So, organizations are no exception, and lots of planning activities are done by the management people at all levels. So, planning is the process of selecting objectives and determining the course of action required to achieve these objectives. So, lots of information has to be gathered and processed before planning is formulated. So, the planning bridges the gap from where we are and where we want to go. Okay, it makes the things possible to occur which would not otherwise happen. So, planning is outlining a future course of action in order to achieve an objective. And planning is looking ahead. So, according to Kunz Vodanol, planning is deciding in advance what to do, how to do, what to do, and who is to do it. So it is the selection among alternatives of future course of action for the enterprise as a whole and each department within it. So plans involve in selecting enterprise objectives and determining ways of achieving them. This is according to O'Donnell. In other words of Mary Rosenthal's, planning is the consist of selecting and developing the best course of action to accomplish an objective. So it is the basis for basis from which future management action springs. Thus the planning primarily focus the future course of action, that is what an action, how to take action, and when to take action to achieve the desired goal. Planning leads to decision making and controlling. Next, we are going to see nature and purpose of planning. So we can say planning is a primary function. How planning is the primary function of a management, and it precedes all functions such as organizing, directing, controlling, etc. There is no meaning of other activities without getting the goals to be achieved and line of action to be followed. So in fact, all other functions of management largely depend on planning. And we can say planning is a dynamic process. Right, so planning is a continuous managerial function, involves complex processes such as perception, analysis, communication, decision, and action. So it is a never ending activity of a manager of an enterprise. So most of the plan are modifying, revising according to the changes in the circumstances. So moreover, a series of plans is to be followed successfully one after the other. So thus the planning process will continue and will never come to an end. Then next nature of purposes in planning is based on objectives and policies. So planning process involves in setting objectives to be achieved and determining the techniques for achieving those objectives. The various techniques such as policies, programs, procedures and or formulated. So objectives determines where we are to go, and planning makes a bridge over where we are and where we want to go. Thus the planning and objectives are related. Okay, next, planning is a selective process. So for achieving a particular objective, there are a number of alternatives available. So the planning manager has to select only one alternative which is best suited to the firm. Thus the planning is one kind of selective process. Next, pervasiveness of planning. So planning is generally considered as a function of top level management, but it is not true. Planning function should spread or make available throughout the organization. Every manager has a planning function to perform. So only the scope of planning differs from person to person depending upon the level of management. Next, planning is an intellectual process. So planning is a mental activity. It is a process where a number of activities are to be taken to decide the future course of action. So various levels of manager have to consider various course of action, achieving the desired goals, the detailed process of every course of action, and then finally decide which course of action may suit them best. Thus the planning is an intellectual action. Then planning is directed towards efficiency. So in generally, all management functions including planning are directed to increase the efficiency of the firm, right? So planning is an intellectual activity that aims the best way of doing things and provides the goals and objectives. Thus the planning is directed towards efficiency. Next, planning is focused with future activities. So planning is primarily concerned with looking into future. So it forecasts the future situation in which the organization has to function. Simply, planning decides the present what is to be done in future. Next one is flexible of planning. So planning is flexible as commitment which is based on future course of action. So these are always dynamic. Therefore, an adjustment is needed between various factors and planning. So planning is based on facts. Planning is not a guesswork or trial and error method. So it is conscious that determining of projecting a course of action for the future. So planning is based on fact, objectives and considered focused. So some quiz question for the who is listening this. The first and foremost function of management is, okay, the options are given: planning, organizing, controlling and coordinating. Just find out it. Okay, then next question is, planning lays down the overall objectives, strategies and policies for the total enterprise. Is just, okay, just you have to find out what is that a corporate planning, a division planning, unit planning or department planning. Okay, thank you. Thanks for listening.